single ear, my father plugged out my earphones and said to me, "Son, remember that if you have bones in your body, you can gain your flesh whenever you want. So please work hard." With these words ringing in my ears, I reached the path. I started to work hard from the first day of the semester itself. I did not consider studies as a burden. Rather, I enjoyed them. Some of my friends might remember me teaching them engineering drawing with the help of my smartphone, with the Alex flashlight to project shadows on them. This rigorous hard work helped me to achieve a brilliant score, and I ended up in the top 0.5%. Are you jealous of my achievement?
Yes.
Yes.
A magician never reveals his trick, but I do. I never believe to be the orthodox talker. I define my own rules. I never consider that it is necessary to sit at the front of the class in order to pay attention. Since my 11th grade, I have found myself much comfortable in the middle portion, or much better, at the back benches. And sitting at the back gives you two advantages. First, you don't strain your neck. And second, in a boarding class, you can do something productive. However, this practice of mine has often pushed me into quite an impasse with many a professor. I remember, I was in my first year, the second semester, the electronics lab. My entire group was performing the experiment, and a professor comes. Looking at me, he says, "Hey, I have never seen you. Do you attend my classes?" "Yes, sir." "Where do you sit?" "At the back, sir." "Ah, so you don't study?" At this point, I just lowered myself and I tried not to laugh. Whereas the Priyanshu inside me was rolling on the floor laughing. Situation spiced up. In life, you have three kinds of friends. First, the friends with whom you converse. Second, your best friends forever, who are an integral part of your life. And third, your good friends, who cannot withstand any insults of you. And I had one such friend in my group. This guy didn't realize, "Sir, he's a topper." And I was like, "What has this guy done?" I was now completely terrified, and I was pretty sure that I would be grilled in the viva the next week. Next week came. Right before the viva, the professor stared right into my eyes. He asked the first question, and I answered it. Some more questions followed, each tougher than the previous one. At the end of the day, I successfully defended myself, and the professor had to admit that I attended his classes. Well, this incident might portray me as Baba, a conqueror, but I was yet to become Akbar, a great emperor. I was yet to have an even upper hand. The most recent and challenging phase of my life has been in this semester itself, the internship season. Internship seasons can be frustrating and stressful, but the key to success is to remain calm. And believe me, meditation can help you a lot in achieving a peaceful mind. Whenever I was a bit anxious, 5 to 10 minutes of meditation proved to be a bliss. During my online coding rounds, I was as calm as a summer sea. Coming to the big day, 21st August, with just one bowl of cornflakes and with the strength of just few hours of sleep, I embarked on the tedious journey to face my life's first interview. For my first interview with Goldman Sachs, I wasn't that confident. But as the day progressed, my confidence built up. The other companies were demanding me as a candidate. They were dying to select me. But Goldman Sachs, they wouldn't allow me to go for other interviews in between their rounds. As a result, at around 3 in the afternoon, I went for Microsoft's interview, but they had become too impatient, and the result was that they rejected me after the first round itself. This devastated me, but I did not lose hope. At around 8 in the night, I went for Samsung's interview. 13 long hours without food. I had performed quite a few. I was so engrossed that all I could think about was the interviews. After that hectic day, I reached my hostel room at 10 o'clock. The results of Goldman Sachs were declared. They rejected me. During the next 15 minutes, there was a plethora of emotions in my mind. Regret of not going for Microsoft's interview first. Frustration of having spent the entire day in pain. 15 minutes later, my phone buzzed. And I saw that the results of Samsung R&D were declared. I downloaded the Excel sheet. I scrolled down the list. The last line of the list matched the pattern. Priyanshu Kumar. After all these years of hard work that has reduced me to bones, it is my time to regain my flesh back and enjoy my life to the fullest. Over to the toastmaster.